Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a three-yard gain.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Again, it's Henry. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the four-yard pickup brings him to third down.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They'll run the option on third and short yardage. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. A good chunk on the ground on the keeper. 17 yards, first down. That may be a sneak peek on this opening drive of what this young rookie can showcase, his legs.
And normally, as you start a game, you're just thinking, can he get the snap? Can he hand off? Can he just execute? Instead, he doesn't waste any time on wrapping another dimension to his game, showing off those wheels and picking up some nice yardage.
To the air on first down, here's Willis. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Willis now off play action. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A new set of downs after a strong pickup of 16 yards.
Robert Woods got to close out his five-year tenure in Los Angeles as a Super Bowl champion. Remember, he began in the NFL with the Buffalo Bills. What a nice ending there out on the West Coast for a consistent receiver who's lost with injury 9 games into 2021. Now, on his next great adventure in Tennessee, where he can immediately form a nice duo with A.J. Brown. Good play for the man they call Bobby Trees. Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Play action. Here's Willis. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
An early message that this secondary is going to be tested because even though it fell incomplete, it almost felt like a warning shot to get things going.
Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. Willis with another keeper, and he is going to lose yardage here. Willis, fourth down here. And that is incomplete. The Titans try it, but ultimately they fail on fourth down. And on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense forces a turnover on downs. Good starting field position for the Colts as they have it first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. A carry by Taylor to start the drive. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. This defense for the Titans, they played really well in the win over the Raiders a week ago.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
Second down, another run with Taylor. And he's up over midfield and down into Tennessee territory. 2 yards on the first down carry, and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Well, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need 6 on third down to keep the drive going. On third down, Ryan. And this throw will be intercepted. Picked off by Kevin Farley. And the Titans are going to get the football here at their own 23.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Well, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game. But I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice. But at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Running from the gun with Henry. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that one. No gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
And for the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on third down. Third down, it's Willis. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. And that'll bring up fourth down on the big sack with a loss of 5. On now is the Titans punter. Back deep, Khalif Raymond. He only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Fielded just inside the 30. A pretty good punt there, but also a nice return of 12 yards. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. Come to the line ready to start their next drive. As the offense comes out here, Charles, maybe perhaps a bit more of a focus on the run game for this drive after tossing an interception on the previous one.
I think that's a good way to look at it and a good way to think about it, but maybe they get to it in a little bit different way because after you throw an interception, you want to make sure you keep your quarterback's confidence high. So maybe give him a couple easy throws that he can complete and then get to the running game and try and get things settled down.
Yeah, and still in the first half here, a long way to go. We're scoreless after one. Run got 6, now 2nd and 4. They run once more with Taylor. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. The Colts at 2-1 now to start the campaign. They were looking good until last week's loss took them from the ranks of the unbeaten.
Yeah, I don't think anyone was expecting this team to push the 72 Dolphins, but still, you got to take a lot of positives from this first month. If they can bounce back and move to 3-1, they'll be pretty well set up for the remainder of the season to follow.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
First and 10, Taylor now. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. Now Ryan. Oh, they would have gotten the conversion if he could hold on. Instead, the drop means it'll be 4th down. Shaking his head after that when they had the play call they wanted.
I'm shaking my head as well. Tight end in this spot, that's a primary chance for him to catch the ball and make a big play, and he didn't get it done.
Jackson's going to try the sneak. Yeah, boy, that's going to be close. He didn't get much at all there, but he got the first. Looked like they might have held him defensively, but the referee signals it will be a first down. Only needed a few inches to pick it up and get behind your center and burrow forward like he did.
And remember what the GMs have told us? We build an offensive line starting with our center, the guy who can make all the line calls and also move those big defensive tackles in order to pick up first downs.
So this offense able to convert on 4th, and now a fresh set of downs here, 1st and 10. A give for Taylor running right side. And he'll get about 5 here as he'll take this down inside the 20-yard line.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. A first throw for the backup, Jackson. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Kevin Byard, the Middle Tennessee Blue Raider, gets the sack. On 3rd down, here's Taylor. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. First and goal from the 3. They're going to run a little pop pass here. Pick up 2. Brings
Second and goal from the one. They'll look to run with Taylor. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Jonathan Taylor, his seventh rushing touchdown on the year. And the Colts post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. The Rodrigo Blankenship now for the PAT. And this is good to make it 7-0 Indy. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. Taken in at the 3. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. Up to midfield. Look at him go inside the 30. And it'll be a terrific return here as he gets it down all the way inside the 30.
I know the special teams coach will not permit himself a smile here, but inside, he's glowing. This is what he practices for. This is what he schemes. This is what he watches tape to put himself and his team in a position to score points, an absolute dream return.
Come on, come on. Hey.
A first down carry for Henry. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage.
On second down, here's a keeper by the QB.
And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. He's able to call his own number for 8 that time, but it leaves him with a third down.
A little do-it-yourself run right there and a nice game.
I like that he knew that that was about all he was going to get, so he did a nice job of protecting himself, took care of the football, took what the defense gave him. If they continue to allow him to do that, they'll find their way taking what they can all the way to the end zone.
Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. They'll run. It's Henry. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Derrick Henry, his third touchdown now on the year.
And the Titans are on the board here in the final minute of the first half. So a big decision there to go on fourth down. Gets him not only the first, but gets him the touchdown as well.
And Brandon, you and I know that all these coaches tell us if every play is executed the way it's designed, it goes for a touchdown. But let's be honest, they were shooting for the first down on that one. And boy, were they fortunate to take it all the way in.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. At the line and set to go. And they've got a little under 40 seconds to go if they want to try to put something together here. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. Throwing is Jackson. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, partner, they're not content to run this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
And this is a confident group. At the very least, they're thinking field goal.
Yeah, and I don't blame them one bit. I don't think you sit on the ball going into the half when you have a chance to put some more points on the board.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave them trying to convert on 3rd and 9.
Seven Pirates!
Now it's Jackson. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. To punt on fourth down, here's Rigoberto Sanchez. They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And that'll be a return of 12 following a very nice punt. And control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything. To the air on first down, here's Willis. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left.
Well, congratulations to them. They come through defensively with another stop. And let's face it, this secondary, they've gone unchallenged so far in the first half.
19 sacks, 19 sacks, 19 sacks.
Last play of the half. Here's Willis. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. He's got a man complete. And they'll work this down inside the 30. So a touchdown apiece. That's what we have to show at halftime as they head to the locker room. 7-7 our score. As we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Second down, another run with Taylor. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points.
18 runner.
Here's Jackson to throw. He's going to look deep for more. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Christian Fulton. And the Titans will have the football as this is taken up past the 30. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that
one. Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
On first down, Willis. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. From the 40 now on second down. Willis looking left side and he's got a man. That's Tate. 7 yards there and a first down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
Well, if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
From just shy of midfield, Willis. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Henry up the middle. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. Second down, here's Willis. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Fabian Moreau. The 20. And he will bring it back. An interception return for Colts TD. So what a turn of events there. You're driving to take the lead in this third quarter, but then one mistake, and you're watching the ball being returned for a touchdown.
Certainly a great example of how focus has to be there on every play, doesn't it, partner? You can't get complacent, and I think that he did. He's got to move him downfield, but that's a play. We just shouldn't have thrown the football, and ultimately could wind up costing him the ball game.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Willis to try again after the pick six. He's airing it out for Williams. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10.
Buffalo 18.
It's a play fake. Here's Willis. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
Yeah, great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Another attempt, another incompletion, and when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points, and the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
Come back, team.
On second and 10, Willis. And his throw is going to be incomplete. What a difference a week makes. Last week he hit on over 80% of his passes. This week he's down under 50%.
seeing a drop. If someone's over 80%, they're not going to hold that number, not in this league. But a drop under 50%, that just tells me that the defense has spent a lot of extra time on game films and came up with a really good plan to try and chip away at his timing.
On third down, it's Willis. And that is incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
A very good return that time. 18 yards.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go.
Here comes another drive from this unit, and Charles, they're coming off a costly mistake on the last possession, an interception in a game that is very close right now.
Well, as we know, they all sting no matter what the situation, but in a one-possession game, that'll hurt a little bit more. But this is an excellent opportunity to make up for it on this drive. I just don't expect them to try and take huge gambles to make up that momentum in a hurry.
An opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the third quarter. What you're trying to do is break the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, melt the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we play three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Colts on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 11. Off the play fake, here's Jackson. This will be taken in by Michael Pittman. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
And that certainly appears to be a critical conversion right there, because not only do they keep the drive going, they take valuable time off the clock as well. They have to feel really good about that last completion.
They give to Taylor out of the gun. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
Again, it's Taylor. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage.
Rodrigo Blankenship with an important one.
This to make it a 2-score game. Blankenship's kick is good. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7.
So that's CD, an important one here in the fourth quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a 2-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a 2-score game, and they were able to get it done.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive.
And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a 2-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly.
throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. Throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%. Right now, he's under 50%.
Well, that comes from extra game film, extra time. You know those guys watched him all week, saw how precise he was, and constructed a defense to try and chip away at that. And thus far, they've been successful.
To throw on second and 10. Willis, he's airing it out for Williams. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10.
19 right.
Willis will look to throw it. Now the pressure comes, and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. N'Kobe Dean in there to drop him, and that will go in the books as the first sack of his young NFL career. Congratulations, young man. Willis, fourth down, has to have it. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Titans try it, but ultimately they fail on fourth down. And now, boy, the ball's going to go over on downs here inside the 10-yard line. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Now Jackson. Got his tight end. That's complete. It's Woods. Touchdown, Colts!
At the top with the clear view. Oh, look, I don't like your energy. I don't like it. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. You an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no. Probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play. All these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. Let's go. You not my kind, not no kin to me. Heard you told my girl about all of them that's DMing me. Why they hogging up the recipe? Heard they talking like I can't let Ken Wallace get ahead of me. Know your heart full of jealousy. All that acting tough. Damn, this must be a parody. Okay, 101 ain't no comparing me. Okay, wait, 2-on-2, that's like for they be sharing me. Okay, they working like the rent do. Rent got them doing, that's what I'm into. Yeah, if I'm in it, then I own it, not a rent too. No, I've been plotting on the lamb and the Benz cool. Yeah, oh, yeah.
Yeah, I don't like your energy. I don't like that. I don't like the fake handshake, snake Tennessee. You an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no. Probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play. All these catching penalty. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake Tennessee. Let's go.
You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the proof. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the proof. You gotta choose. Yeah, I jump out the booth. Then I might hop through the roof. Got all the rings. My team is the truth, but they some lies to you. And they never sing, huh? But they always shoot. And all of their diamonds are new. And that's why I'm here with Villain, cause I really get it. And I need all my honeys in blue. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the proof. You gotta choose. Make a choice. I need 100 packs for my boys. Did be hating and talking and talking and hating. I bet you I kill the noise. I've been a man like I'm painting. I boost up my rating. You know how I play with toys. Pop out on any occasion, get standing ovations. They can't help it but rejoice. They all wanna follow me. Cause I got my foot on the opposition neck and ain't no apologies. 100 yards, you know I own all the property. Daddy's home, you know I own all the property. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the proof. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the proof. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the proof. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the proof. You gotta choose.
Fish, fish. Better not leave a minute, stop it. Something like the gold off in their pocket. Whole squizzy riding with me, who gon' stop it? My day ones, yeah, the dance at the beginning. So you know it's only right, that's how we end. Came all the way from losing to winning. Yeah, I did it. But it ain't just me, it's the whole team. Share it with the whole team. Congratulate the whole team. Know when you riding like we riding with each other. Ain't no hiding. It's the whole team. Share it with the whole team. Congratulate the whole team. Cause when you riding like we riding with each other. Ain't no hiding.
Okay, say no more. Tell the chauffeur to open Mercedes door. Put the pedal to metal and made it soar. She was, but I made it sure. It was, so we stayed indoors. Let's take it where no one has been before. It feel like I've known you some years before, but I don't know.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a Lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply rapidocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you are, we own it. I'm doing big things in my life. I deserve 6 rings like a mic. I've got a no sleep. I remember when it was the nosebleeds. Now they captured the fashion from flow seats. I'm a whole king.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a Lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you are, we own it. Ooh, it's trouble in paradise. So let's parachute where the air's nice. And let's risk it all on the paradise. But she just wanna make sure her hair's nice. That's fair, right? I just fell in love with a prima donna. The 2023 Madonna. I mean, your honor, I was minding my business until she gave me complete nirvana.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a Lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you are, we own it.
Let's go.
I am the greatest.
You seen the making of a star.